Hi, I'm Dr. Divya Negi Ghai. Welcome to my life page. Today we will talk about social entrepreneurship. But first let me tell you about myself. I did a B Ed when I started teaching in schools, but I got bored in 2 years, so then I enrolled for a PhD. I completed my PhD. In the process, I got married, I had my first son, and then after that I joined a private university here. During another maternity break, I wrote a book called Stop Fooling Yourself. After completing the book, I started promoting the book, I started taking seminars in schools and colleges, and then I realized that when I was a faculty in the college, I used to wonder that why are we doing all these seminars and guest lecture with students which are of no use to them. They don't get any benefit from them. So why can't we do something which stays regularly with them? That was the idea with which I started Youth Rocks Foundation, where we want to be in touch with the students, whether they are college students or school students or dropouts. I think every youth is important for us, and we believe that we have to be talking to these young people, guiding them, helping them and taking their suggestions and helping them decide their future path in the long run. It is basically just like being any other entrepreneur, but you are here trying to solve a problem. You are trying to solve a social problem which you can see, but you are not getting a solution for that. So what do you do? How do you find a solution for that? Something which is scalable, something which can be replicated, and something which can be followed by others all around the country, all around the world. That is social entrepreneurship all about. Now, as we are saying that the understanding of a particular field is important in this area, but that understanding alone is not enough, because you know, as you understand, everything is interrelated. If there is a social problem, it will have its political connections, it will have its legal connections, it will have its economic repercussions. So you need to understand what is this problem, why this problem is coming in the society, why we are not yet able to solve this problem. Communication skills, because see, you will be writing project proposals, you will be sending emails, you will be writing formal, informal letters to people, you will be messaging. Everything throughout the day that we do through the social media is also communication. So you should be effective in that. You should know how to write those things effectively and nicely and politely. First thing which comes to our mind is the fulfillment that it is going to bring to you. The way you feel satisfied when you look at other people who problems you have been able to solve, people who look up to you, who reach out to you with their problems, and you are able to solve their problems, you are able to help them, you are able to guide them. The results are very slow. You will keep on meeting the same people, you will keep on making them understand what the problems and what the solutions are, but it is not going to happen like you will have a meeting and it will be solved. It will take a lot of time, that needs a lot of patience. The results are going to be very slow. Sometimes they will be quick, sometimes they will be able to understand what you are saying and they will be ready for the change. But generally people are not like that. It takes time for them to go out of their comfort zone and understand. Generally the day is long, and because I have young kids, so I try to keep all my meetings outside of the office in the first half before lunch. So I try to keep all the meetings till 2 or 3 o'clock. I try to wind up all the meetings wherever I have to go to, the sessions that I am taking in various schools and colleges, all that has to be, generally I try to wind it up by 2 or 3 o'clock. And then in the afternoon, 3 to 5 is a time which I have kept for myself. I do some reading, I spend some time with the kids, and I do any other kind of personal meetings that I have to do. And then in the evenings, I have to be with the kids. I spend time with them, like whatever the school work etc. is. And along with that, till late night, I am working on my laptop, because that is what needs a lot of your time and attention in this field. So I have to research a lot, I have to read a lot, I have to go through various studies which are happening around the world, the things that experts are talking about and the projects that we are going to propose. So that a lot of hard work, a lot of research goes into that. So generally towards the end of the day, I spend time on that. So that is the entire day, how it is, how I live every day. I hope I have given you a balanced overview of the life of a social entrepreneur. Thank you.